di acara ngojek.
Apa itu ngojek?
Ngojek itu ngobrol jenius kekinian.
Ngojek ngobrol jenius kekinian.
Halo semuanya, kembali lagi sama kita di Ngojek Ngobrol Jenius Kekinian. Maaf ya kalau misalnya tadi ada sedikit trouble. Tapi kita mengusahakan yang terbaik supaya teman-teman di sini juga bisa berpartisipasi ya sama kita untuk tahu nih, tahu tentang meditasi.
Tadi kan kita udah ngomongin soal UTS ya.
Ya,
bagaimana UTSmu?
Ya, puji Tuhan baik.
Semoga yang lain, teman-teman yang lain yang udah UTS, semoga upernya tidak banyak. Iya. Meskipun uper nggak apa-apa teman-teman, masih bisa diperbaiki.
Betul, semangat.
Terus buat yang angkatan 22 nih, semoga pas tanggal 31 mulai UTS tetap semangat juga.
Iya. Nah, ini kan yang paling ditunggu-tunggu nih, yaitu kita masuk ke acara inti dari project ini. Dan mungkin kalian nanti kayak, oh ada yang baru di sini.
Iya dong. Ada yang spesial.
Iya, kita akan ngobrol seputar meditasi bersama ahlinya.
Welcome Bro Guna. Yeay.
Thanks Bro Guna.
It's our honor to welcome you here. It's your second time to here, right?
Yes.
So, before I ask some question,
sure.
I want to ask permission from you that I will ask some question in Bahasa and okay. She will translate in English. Aku juga mau inget nih, buat teman-teman kalau misalkan ada pertanyaan bisa langsung aja chat di kolom Zoom ya, atau bisa langsung di live YouTube, ya kan? Oke. Okay. Nah, untuk pertanyaan pertama, Oli nanti bisa translate-nya ya.
Ya, yeah, oke.
Okay. Jadi nih, sesuai dengan tema kita hari ini tentang meditation to improve mental wellness, saya sendiri dan kami di sini ingin bertanya mengenai opini dari Bruna tentang keseimbangan mental terutama pada remaja.
So we're talking about mental wellness right today. So according to that, we want to hear from your self-opinion. How do you see about teenagers in their youth era about their mental health? And if their mental wellness is not in the right condition or it's not stable, what impact that they can have?
Oh, mental wellness is a big word these days around the world. It's not just here. A lot of mental wellness issues comes from various situations in the young people's life. I would say some of them come from abusive families, broken homes, and then they also have problems like in school. You know, there's always this bullying things going on, right? That's one. And then there's some violent behaviors of people that's caused them abuse, abusive. It could be in the family, it could be in school, you know, it could be outside somewhere else. Many of them come from broken homes, basically means single parents. There's only one parent, and they feel there's something missing in the family. These are some of the situations that has impacted a young person's life as they're growing up. And I feel that there will be tendencies for them to start looking elsewhere for support.
Yes.
And but we don't know what kind of support. You know, sometimes it can be positive, sometimes it can be negative.
Jadi kalau buat teman-teman yang mungkin belum tahu tadi Bruna bilang apa, aku akan mencoba mentranslatekan kan ya. Jadi kalau untuk masalah mental wellness ini itu biasanya sering banget ya terjadi di kalangan anak-anak muda kayak kita sekarang ini. Biasanya bisa dari physical abuse dari rumah atau dari sekolah, atau juga bisa dari masalah dari rumah, misal karena orang tuanya bercerai,
masalah ekonomi orang tua juga mempengaruhi ya.
Terus bully. Bully tuh kayaknya banyak banget ya masalah di sekolah-sekolah.
Itu bukan hal yang baik, tapi udah jadi kayak something biasa nggak sih?
Iya, betul banget. Terus juga masalah sosial, tekanan dari lingkungan-lingkungan itulah yang membuat kita tuh kadang merasa terpressure, merasa stres gitu kan. Kita tuh pasti nyari kayak apa ya, nyari bantuan ke orang tapi bingung. Ini tuh positif nggak ya buat aku atau negatif nggak ya buat aku, kayak gitu. Next question, kira-kira dengan permasalahan anak muda zaman sekarang, perkuliahan atau masalah-masalah lain yang mengikuti, apakah bisa diselesaikan literasi? Dan kalau bisa nih, mengapa?
So we're talking about meditation now. Is it possible meditation can help the teenagers to facing the issues that we talked before? And if it's possible, why and how does it work?
Oh, of course, meditation is very, very helpful. The earlier the age that you start doing meditation, the better for you. Meditation helps to calm the mind. You know, there's a sense of inner peace at the same time. Meditation has so many other benefits. You're more focused. You can also be, ready to engage yourself with any activity with a positive mindset. But mostly it's meditation is about calming yourself, bringing inner peace so that you are more stable and centered in your personality as well.
So, tadi kita sudah ngomong ya, kalau misalnya meditasi itu sebenarnya benar-benar ampuh ya buat menetralkan pikiran. Logikanya ya guys ya, kalau misalnya kita udah tenang nih ya, namanya kita punya problem, pasti nyelesainya juga lebih gampang,
ya,
lebih easy untuk diselesaikan. Jadi kalian harus nyoba sih, karena kita berdua tadi udah nyoba, dan emang se-relax itu.
Iya, seperti yang kita udah omongin di awal, kalau meditasi itu membuat kita lebih tenang. Terus untuk pertanyaan selanjutnya, kira-kira manfaat apa aja yang bisa kita dapetin kalau misalnya kita sudah meditasi?
Okay, so what kind of benefit that teenagers can have from the meditation?
Yeah, like I said before, it helps you to be more calm.
Mm-hmm.
And I think earlier you guys were talking about 60,000 to 80,000 thoughts.
Yes.
So how to reduce the thoughts?
Yeah.
Lesser thoughts. 60,000 to 80,000 thoughts are not very helpful. There's all kinds of data going on. So the idea is to bring meditation helps you to bring the number of thoughts down. When you have lower thoughts, less busy the mind, and you get less stress.
Yes.
Right? Because the mind machine is running automatically and there's no control. So the idea is to help reduce the number of thoughts. Right? And of course, it allows you to have a much more balanced body, because if the mind is well, the body is well. If the body is well, you don't feel tired, you don't feel stressed, you know, you don't feel upset or lazy or, you know, inactive. So those are some wonderful benefits. You have to try it and you will understand how it feels. It's very difficult to explain a lot of things now.
You're talking about that and I wonder why we have 60,000 to 80,000 thoughts. That's so many.
Jadi dari yang dibicarakan sama Bruna itu, kalau meditasi seperti yang kita bilang, meditasi itu buat kita jadi tenang. Tadi kan disinggung sama Olin juga bahwa meditasi bahwa kita tuh punya pikiran 60,000 sampai 80,000 per harinya gitu. Itu kan kayak
sebenarnya kita apa sih yang kita pikirkan?
Ya, apa yang kita pikirkan gitu kan. Jadi kalau misalnya pikiran kita tenang, badan kita tuh jadi lebih enak gitu. Lebih mau ngapain tuh gak capek gitu kan ya. Nah, untuk selanjutnya nih, kira-kira tips yang bisa dilakukan supaya meditasi ini bisa dilakukan dengan mudah dan bisa dilakukan di mana saja.
Okay, so do you have any special tips for the audience so they can do the meditation easily? Because meditation needs a high focus, but gain some focus for teenagers is one of the hardest things. So maybe you have that special tips for them.
Yeah. What I can say is meditation can be easy, but at the beginning it's always very hard. Mm-hmm. It's difficult. You will have to practice it.
Yes.
On a regular basis, consistently.
Yeah.
It's like you want to build your body, you go to the gym, right? To
work out.
And you must go every day.
Yeah.
And then have that muscle building. It's the same thing with the mind also. You have to do the meditation every day so that it builds the routine, it builds the habit. Right? So it is difficult at the beginning, but you must have the determination to push on. You can join a group and do it with a group of people so there will be more support. Also, you could do it with a friend and then motivate each other to do the meditation.
Yes.
Right? Trying to do alone is always very difficult, so it's best to join a group.
Yeah.
And get some what we call group support, and then eventually you start learning how to do it on your own.
Okay.
Yeah. So other than that, you know, make sure you have a nice, peaceful environment. Mm-hmm. You know, make sure your electronic devices are off and not disturbing you. And let's say, don't do meditation just after eating because it's going to be very sleepy. So
So I'm agree with that.
With empty stomach, it's good, which means if you can do it in the morning when you wake up, it's great. Otherwise, 2 hours after eating.
Okay.
Right? But it's never to do it in a full stomach. It's going to be very difficult. Yeah.
Yes.
And of course, you must have that discipline. Right? Yeah. One of the things is, if you want to be good in anything, you must have the discipline and the ability to keep doing it consistently.
Yeah.
Now, the main word here is consistent. Have a schedule. That's fine.
Nah guys, intinya tuh kita harus konsisten dan disiplin ya, cari lingkungan yang aman, yang tenang, yang peaceful. Terus coba di awal-awal sama teman-temannya, terhabis itu nanti deh kalau udah mulai terbiasa baru kita bisa sendiri. Dan hindari saat udah makan ya.
Iya.
Kita kondisi biasa aja ngantuk ya, apalagi dibuat meditasi gitu ya.
Kan? Kalau makan meditasi tidur yang ada
ya, kan. Betul. Nah, itu dia. Nah, sebelum kita masuk untuk nanya-nanya dulu nih sama Bro Kuna, dan kita mau praktis nih kayaknya di sini ya kan. Kita bakalan nampilin satu iklan yang mungkin bisa bikin kalian lebih teracuni gitu.
Masuk teracuni loh.
Ya kan, siapa tahu kalau kalian masuk sini kan bisa punya kesempatan buat ngobrol kayak gitu.
Oh iya benar.
Iya kan? So, check it out.
Dulu tuh ya, aku tuh punya impian menjadi perawat loh, yang bisa menolong, membantu sesama.
Lah, itu bagus dong. Jadi perawat itu kerjaan yang mulia loh, dan aku mau kasih informasi nih.
Wah, emang apa? Berkaitan dengan dunia keperawatan ya?
Iya dong, Distrikes Katolik Santo Vincentius A. Paulo, Surabaya. Sekolah perawat dan fisioterapis D3 dan S1 di Surabaya. Di sana, selain jurusan perawat, ada juga loh fisioterapinya. Kamu ingin terjun di dunia keperawatan atau fisioterapi? Stikes Katolik Santo Vincentius A. Paulo, Surabaya. Pilihan yang tepat.
Iya, sudah terbukti kualitasnya. Mahasiswa mampu lulus 100% uji kompetensi. Masa tunggu lulusan 2,8 bulan saja, terakreditasi B.
Memiliki rumah sakit sendiri untuk praktek RSK Santo Vincentius A. Paulo atau RKJ Surabaya. Menjalin kerja sama luar negeri dengan St. Paul University Filipina. Fuyen University, Taiwan.
Stikes Katolik Santo Vincentius A. Paulo, Surabaya mempersembahkan acara talk show Ngobrol Jenius Kekinian atau Gojek rutin setiap hari Sabtu, Minggu kedua dan keempat jam 9 pagi di YouTube Stikvins, Surabaya.
Catat tanggalnya ya, pada hari Sabtu, tanggal 27 Maret 2021, jam 9 pagi dengan tema Mengenal lebih dalam tentang vaksin COVID-19 bersama pembicara Dr. Friska Suprianto.
Jangan lupa follow Instagram Stikvins, Stikvins SBY, atau ambil posternya lalu sebarkan sebanyak-banyaknya dan dapatkan hadiahnya.
Jangan lupa ya, juga like and subscribe. Nyalakan loncengnya YouTube channel Sting Fins Surabaya.
Satunya di sini, di Zoom. Oke. Halo semuanya, kembali lagi di Ngocek Ngobrol Jenius Kekinian. Nah, tadi kan kita udah sempat singgung-singgung sedikit nih, kita juga udah tanya-tanya juga tentang meditasi. Ternyata udah ada yang tanya di kolom chat Zoom nih, Olin. Kira-kira dari ini dari Suster Maria Magdalena. Bagaimana cara kita menggunakan mantra dalam bermeditasi?
Mantra?
Yes. Dan efek positif apa yang bisa kita dapatkan saat bermeditasi?
Oh, okay. So, there's a question for you.
Yes.
How we use some spell when we do the meditation, and again, what's the what kind of benefit that we can have?
I heard the word mantra just now.
Yes, yeah. Mantras.
So, mantra is more like you're chanting something.
Ah, you're chanting, like.
Right? It's like chanting, like it's saying like, I'm healthy, well, and happy, I'm healthy, well.
So like an affirmation word.
It's sort of affirmation, but it's more like it becomes a chanting thing. It's also a kind of a meditation because you're totally focused on those words, which is okay to do, right? But after a while, you know, that word is automatically running in your mind. I'm healthy, I'm well, I'm happy, and so on. Whatever mantra you want to have, it's of course it's a good thing to practice, right? But the idea is to go to the next level to try and quieten even those words, right? So to try to discipline yourself in the beginning, you can use a mantra so that you're learning how to focus.
Okay.
Then after that, maybe you can go to the next level to try and quieten the mind. You already feel, I'm happy, I'm healthy, I'm happy. Right? Once the vibration is there, you can quieten the mind even more.
So if I can say the mantra is like
a suggestion.
Yeah,
it's sort of a suggestion.
The way for us so we can be focused.
Yeah. Okay. There are many mantras that you can use. Like you wake up in the morning and say, thank you for another beautiful day.
Okay.
You know, like, you can say that. That's your first mantra. The most simplest mantra that I can think about is just saying thank you for everything. You know?
Yeah.
The whole day as you're walking around, doing things or receiving things, you're just saying thank you. You know? Thank you to your friend, or thank you to, you know, I have a home. Thank you that I have food. Thank you that I have clothes to wear. So, thank you is unlimited. You can say it 1,000 times in a day.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful mantra.
So if I can say when I do the meditation, I can say I'm beautiful, I'm kind, I'm smart. So it can decrease some insecurities, right?
Well, if you're sure that you're beautiful, you don't have to say it. Right? You just have to believe. Yeah.
Yes.
But most people want to say the mantra so that they increase their belief in themselves.
Their self-confidence.
Yeah. But usually when someone wants to say a mantra, it's normally about, you know, it's about my health.
Yeah.
Like I have a healthy mind and a beautiful mind, and I'm always thinking positive. It's something that is something that isn't happening to you right now, and you want it so much.
It's purchasing for us,
right? So for those who are like having mental challenges, issues, that's a great mantra to try and start doing, because when you say like I have a healthy, wonderful, and beautiful mind, you know, and I'm always thinking positive. It works wonders. It will help.
Okay.
Mantras like that. Special mantras where it's designed just for yourself. Right? If anybody wants a mantra that's designed for you, let me know. I'll write out something for you.
Okay. Nah, jadi guys, pertama buat Star Maria Magdalena ya, ceritanya ya. Jadi mantra itu sebenarnya bisa melakukan karena itu something positif ya buat kita. Jadi kalau bisa aku simpulkan itu menjadi salah satu titik kita untuk fokus juga. Jadi kita sambil meditasi bisa fokus, kita mengucapkan kayak aku sehat, terima kasih untuk hari ini, aku baik saja, hari ini bakal bisa lebih lancar.
Berarti kata-kata yang bisa apa ya membuat diri kita jadi lebih positif gitu.
Iya. Jadi nanti bawaannya sepanjang hari itu happy terus gitu.
Happy. Jadi enggak overthinking.
Ya, enggak overthinking terus ya kan.
Nah, terus ada pertanyaan lagi nih dari Veronica Silalahi. Ya, Bu Vero ya. Berapa lama waktu yang paling efektif buat meditasi?
Berapa lama waktu yang efektif buat meditasi? Oh, so when exactly for meditasi? The exact time for meditation.
Well, any time is good, but the best time is to wake up in the morning. The first thing you do is do meditation.
Oh, okay. Like
if you wake up in the morning, because I know a lot of young people don't wake up in the morning. So
open phone. I know.
So you can do it any time actually. Yeah. As I said, as long as your tummy is not full of food and you have a quiet space, you can sit there and you can do it sitting on a chair or you can do it sitting on the floor.
Okay. Right?
So if you are having a school break and you can just go somewhere near the tree, you know, where there's nature, you can just sit there, close your eyes and just breathe in and breathe out and just focus on your breathing in and breathing out.
Okay.
It's a great way to start a form of meditation.
Mm-hmm. Is it okay after do the meditation we continue with the praying?
Of course, course. Yes, because you know they say prayer is you talking to God.
Yes.
But meditation is God talking to you.
Ah, that's beautiful. Right?
Because everything is open in your mind.
Yeah. Well, it's magical.
Yeah, that's what they say.
Okay.
I experience that all the time.
Jadi waktu yang paling efektif buat kita bermeditasi itu waktu bangun tidur ya, lagi freshnya. Biasanya kan kalau kita sukanya buka HP gitu kan, tapi ini kalau kita dengan meditasi itu yang mungkin kita bisa menjalani hari-hari kita tuh dengan baik, nggak ada tekanan-tekanan. Dan yang paling penting jangan makan dulu ya teman-teman.
Iya betul. Dan itu oke banget kalau misalnya habis meditasi kalian bisa lanjut sholat, lanjut doa pagi, lanjut saat teduh, it's fine. Gitu. Malah lebih magic.
Lebih tenang juga.
Ya, betul.
Oke, ini kita akan ada satu pertanyaan lagi sebelum kita ke praktik meditasinya ya, Olin. Jadi ini pertanyaan dari Sidi Meta. Halo, Meta.
Hey, friend.
Oke, selamat pagi Bro Kuna. Saya mau bertanya, bagaimana bila sedang kita meditasi terus ada muncul pikiran-pikiran lain? Dan menurut pengalaman sendiri dari Bro Kuna dan tim, adakah remaja yang rutin menjalani meditasi?
Oh, okay. So, when we do meditation, at some point, if we get distracted with other mind, how we face it, how we solve it, and based on you and your team experience, is there any teenagers who do meditation as a routine lifestyle?
Well, I will agree with you that it is not difficult to keep the mind present.
Yes.
Because it will start to wander away.
Yeah.
Yes.
One of the best meditation a person can do is focusing on the breath in and the breath out. So with your eyes closed, you're feeling the air entering in and entering out, and that's where your focus is all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Just stay there. If your mind wanders to school or to something else or to children or whatever it is, bring the mind back. Bring the mind back to focus on that breathing in and breathing out again.
Okay.
So here, so the focus is always around you, feeling the breath in and the breath out. And the mind wanders, say, come back to the focus here.
Mm-hmm.
I think that would be the easiest, simplest technique to follow in order to develop what you call a disciplined form of doing meditation to the next level.
Okay.
Yeah. Does that answer the question?
Yes, and second question. Yeah. Based on you and your team experience, is there any teenagers that do meditation as routine?
Yes.
it's beginning to become, meditation is beginning to become, in the West, if they're introducing it into the school system to young children. I know some of my clients, and they've learned meditation and they're teaching it to the children. So the children from a very young age are sitting with the parents and doing meditation.
Oh, that's cute. Right?
Whether the child knows what to do or not what to do. I mean, you're talking about 6 years old, 5 years old, 7 years old, just sitting there. They're just copying what the parents are doing, but they don't have 60,000 thoughts yet.
Yes.
You know, they're much younger, so they have lesser thoughts. All they know is that they just close their eyes and they remain silent. Right? They just remain silent. Whether something is going on or not, that's different. But when you get a little bit older, like 9 years old, 10 years old, 11, 12, you know, the meditation becomes much more much more purposeful and meaningful, because they start to understand that meditation helps them to silence the thoughts, quieten the mind, lessen the thoughts. And I think I have a lot of clients that I know who are practicing meditation. My team, we are all practicing meditation all the time. And anytime we get just a few minutes away from your work, or your assignment, or your duty, or whatever, take that moment to just connect with yourself and find the in-breath and out-breath.
Okay.
And so, the earlier in life you start meditation, the better it is. Mm-hmm. Really, I'm telling you. I'll just give you an example. When I went to India, all the schools in India have started doing yoga and meditation first thing in the morning.
Yes.
So the children are all balanced and calm and steady before they start studying the subjects. Okay. Right? So they always have a calm and peaceful, attitude and personality, and that allows them to do the studies much better. They're not confused and disturbed. Right? So this is some of the things I personally see with my own eyes, and the government there is making this compulsory to all schools now. So children start at a very early age. You're talking about kindergarten onwards.
Oh.
It's not just grown-up kids, you know, it's kindergarten onwards.
Oh, well, it's really helpful, yes, right? Yeah. So we can be more easier to understand the subject.
Exactly. Yeah, you don't have too much disturbance.
Yes.
When the lecturer is talking something and your mind is disturbed with something else.
Yes.
Right. So you can absorb, you know, the message and the teaching so easily, the knowledge so easily, because there's so much of disturbance.
Yes.
Right. Yeah. But I know the shortcut now is to do recording, but that's not that's not really going to help, because it's actually capturing the essence of the lecturer's knowledge. That's what we're talking about. So the sooner you practice meditation, much much better for you in the long term.
Apakah Steve Finn perlu seperti itu?
Coba gitu ya.
Semoga betah.
Iya.
Jadi buat Meta dan buat teman-teman yang lain.
Ya, betul.
Jadi Rukuna tadi bilang ya bahwa setuju juga kalau misalnya pikiran itu memang gampang untuk teralihkan. Cuman akan lebih gampang kalau misalnya kita fokus ke pernafasan. Ya, jadi pernafasan. Kayak tadi kayak mantra, pernafasan juga sama. Jadi kayak one of ways supaya kita bisa fokus tuh di situ juga. Dan ya, betul. Apakah anak-anak, apakah ada remaja yang juga melakukan sebagai rutinitas? Ada. Ya. Dan bahkan di negara barat dan juga di India itu mereka mempraktikkan itu ya. Mempraktikkan itu bahkan setiap pagi ya,
sebelum mulai pelajaran.
Mulai pembelajaran. Jadi mereka jadi lebih tenang, lebih gampang juga buat memahami materi.
Ya,
itu kenapa kita harus mengajukan itu ke
Atua Stikers. Stikers bisa dicoba ya, nanti siapa tahu kita biar otaknya enggak panas.
Iya.
Pak Arif. Pak Arif mungkin kalau nonton ya kan. Coba metodenya gitu kan.
Iya Pak.
Nah, tadi kan kita sudah dulu ya pertanyaannya.
Iya, oh iya benar juga. Tapi ada satu hal nih dari kita sendiri.
Oh iya.
Kan, so after this, we're going to have some practice with you.
Yes. Right.
But first of all, we want to ask you, is there anything that we need to prepare before we do the meditation?
Yeah. You can either sit on a chair or you can sit on the floor if you're comfortable.
Yes.
So if you sit on the floor, it's good to have a bantal, a cushion.
Oh yeah.
Ah yes.
Right. So that you know you don't feel so painful. also, make sure your device off. Electronics are off.
Yeah.
And that there's no disturbance around.
Yeah.
If you have not eaten yet, just hold on.
Oh, okay.
Right,
okay.
And then I think your clothing should not be too tight.
Oh,
so
yes.
Keep it
yes,
loose,
yes. Yeah.
So that when you sit, you don't feel anything pressing into your body. Mm. Right. Mm. I think that's about it. It's quite the requirements are very little. Yeah.
Jadi step-step yang bisa kita lakukan sebelum kita bermeditasi itu kita bisa bajunya ini jangan terlalu
ya,
ketat supaya kita nyaman juga. Terus ingat jangan makan dulu. Terus juga HP-nya,
HP semua, iPad, tablet
ya, itu dimatikan.
Terus kalian juga bisa milih kok, bisa di kursi, bisa di lantai, kalau di lantai juga bisa pakai bantal.
Bantal biar gak sakit. Kita tahu kalian remaja cupu, bisa apa-apa.
Jadi pakai itu biar gak sakit.
Iya, betul banget.
Nah, so now it's time to practice.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right. So we will have some instructions also before we start
meditation. Yes.
And if you're sitting on a chair, you know, it's not like this.
So just like this.
It has to be more sitting upright. Duduk tegak, isn't it?
Yeah, duduk tegak. Yes.
Upright, so you keep your spine straight. Yeah.
Okay.
Right. Keep your spine straight, and then you can keep your hands facing down or facing up. Doesn't matter. Just relax. Right. And then and just wait for the instructions.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
Relax. Don't be too tense. Just relax, and then just breathe as per normal, and then. We'll give you the instructions. What next to happen?
Okay. Jadi aku I will translate for the audience.
Yes,
okay.
Of course.
Jadi untuk teman-teman kita bisa langsung mempraktekkan meditasi ini. Yang pertama kalian duduk yang apa yang nyaman ya.
Yeah.
Duduk di atas kursi ataupun yeah. bisa di lantai juga.
Jangan leleh ya.
Iya jangan leleh ya. Gitu kan jangan gini.
Jangan gini itu jangan.
Nah, terus habis itu kalian bisa meletakkan kedua tangan kalian di atas paha. Terus telapak tangannya menghadap ke atas.
Bisa kayak gini, bisa gini.
Ya.
It's up to you.
Ya, terus itu jaga punggung. Kita tetap tegak ya, supaya gak liyeh-liyeh itu
yeah,
tadi ya.
Gitu. Nah, terus juga habis ini screen-nya kita bakalan dimatiin buat sebentar. Jadi kalian benar-benar harus fokus ya di pendengaran. Kita bakalan dikasih instruksi dari guru Muna dan pokoknya kita fokus.
Iya, betul.
Oke, sekarang dimatikan dalam 3, 2, 1, off.
Oke, let's start the meditation.
Kita akan mulai meditasinya.
Yeah. Sit comfortably, either on a chair or on the ground.
Duduk dengan nyaman, baik di atas kursi ataupun di lantai.
Place your hands on your thigh, palms facing up or down.
Letakkan tangan di atas paha, lalu telapak tangan menghadap ke atas ataupun ke bawah.
And keep your back upright.
Jaga punggung untuk tetap tegak.
And just relax.
Relax.
And now just close your eye and focus on the breath in and out.
Pejamkan mata dan fokuskan pada nafas kalian.
And keep your awareness there.
Rasakan tarikan dan hembusan nafas.
Breathe in and out through your nose.
Bernafas masuk dan keluar hanya melalui hidung.
Relax the tight muscles on your face.
Relaxkan otot-otot di wajah.
Relax the neck muscles, the shoulder muscles, the upper back.
Kita relax untuk otot-otot leher, bahu, dan bisa punggung-punggung atas.
Relax the lower back, arms and legs.
Relaxkan pinggang bawah, lengan, dan kaki.
And there's nothing to think about, only listening to the instructions.
Relaxkan pikiran, jangan ada pikiran, dan dengarkan instruksi yang diberikan.
Right, no phone, no homework, no people. Just you by yourself.
Tidak ada telepon ataupun tidak ada PR, tidak ada orang-orang lain, hanya Anda sendiri.
And we will do a breathing sequence now. Count to four, breathe in. Hold to four, count. Breathe out to 4 count.
Tarik nafas 4 hitungan. Tahan nafas 4 hitungan. Hembuskan nafas 4 hitungan.
So, kita mulai sekarang. Tarik nafas 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Keluar nafas 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Tarik nafas 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Keluar 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Tarik 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Keluar 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Tarik 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Keluar 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Tarik 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Keluar 2, 3, 4. Tahan 2, 3, 4. Relax. Let's start the peaceful meditation, mindfulness meditation.
Kita akan mulai untuk peaceful place mindfulness meditation.
Okay. Let's go to a place. Let's go to a place you know where you feel peaceful.
Mari kita pergi ke tempat yang Anda ketahui di mana Anda merasa damai.
Or else you can create a place in your mind where you feel at peace.
Atau Anda juga dapat menciptakan tempat dalam pikiran Anda sendiri di mana Anda merasa damai.
Imagine that you are now there.
Bayangkan Anda berada di sana sekarang.
What do you see around you?
Apa yang Anda lihat di sekitar Anda?
Do you see trees or flowers?
Apakah Anda melihat pohon atau bunga?
Or do you see water, river?
Atau apakah Anda melihat air atau sungai?
Maybe a pond, a lake, a sea, or a waterfall.
Mungkin kolam, danau, laut, atau air terjun.
What colors do you see?
Warna apa yang Anda lihat?
And where is the sun at this time?
Di mana matahari saat ini?
Is it rising? Is it setting? Is it noon? Or is it in the evening?
Apakah terbit? Apakah terbenam? Apakah siang atau malam?
Is there a moon? Do you see stars in the sky?
Apakah ada bulan? Atau apakah Anda melihat bintang di langit?
Does it feel cool? Or you feel warm?
Apakah terasa sejuk atau Anda merasa hangat?
What makes this place special?
Apakah terasa sejuk atau apakah yang membuat tempat itu spesial?
What makes this place peaceful?
Apa yang membuat tempat itu istimewa?
There is no one there, just yourself.
Tidak ada seorang pun, hanya diri Anda sendiri.
You are feeling safe. You are feeling calm.
Anda merasa aman, Anda merasa tenang.
You feel happy and you feel grateful.
Anda merasa bahagia dan Anda merasa bersyukur.
You feel immense peace and love in your heart.
Anda merasakan kedamaian dan cinta yang luar biasa di hati Anda.
Your breath is calm and soft and smooth.
Nafas Anda tenang, lembut, dan halus.
And your mind is free from everything.
Pikiran Anda bebas dari segalanya.
This is your favorite peaceful place.
Ini adalah tempat damai favorit Anda.
Next time, when you feel stressed, you know where you can go to find peace.
Lain kali, ketika Anda merasa stres, Anda tahu kemana Anda dapat pergi untuk menemukan kedamaian.
All you have to do is just close your eyes.
Yang harus Anda lakukan hanyalah memejamkan mata.
And as you breathe it, next, you say to yourself, I have arrived.
Saat Anda menarik nafas berikutnya, Anda berkata pada diri sendiri, saya telah tiba.
As you breathe out, you say to yourself, I am home.
Saat Anda menghembuskan nafas, Anda berkata pada diri sendiri, saya berada di rumah.
Just enjoy and stay in this peaceful place for a few more seconds.
Nikmati saja dan tinggal di tempat yang damai ini selama beberapa saat lagi.
So let us now end this meditation session with an affirmation. Just listen.
Mari kita akhiri sesi meditasi ini dengan afirmasi. Dengarkan saja.
Dalam kehidupan yang tak terbatas di mana saya berada, semuanya sempurna, utuh, lengkap. Saya stabil. Stabil dan seimbang. Saya terus-menerus menjadi lebih baik setiap hari. Fokus saya adalah pada apa yang penting bagi saya setiap hari. Saya menjaga pikiran dan emosi saya tetap positif dan kuat. Saya tidak mengizinkan orang lain untuk mengintimidasi saya. Semuanya adalah proses belajar, yang baik maupun buruk. Saya tahu bahwa saya adalah kekuatan di dunia saya. Saya yang bertanggung jawab. Saya menyadari bahwa saya menginginkan perubahan. Saya menyambut perubahan dalam hidup saya, sehingga saya baik untuk saya dan orang lain. Saya melakukan yang terbaik yang saya bisa. Dan saya menjadikan setiap hari istimewa, lebih baik, dan lebih mudah. Hari ini adalah hari yang indah karena saya memilih untuk membuatnya indah. Besok adalah hari yang indah juga. Semuanya baik-baik saja di dunia saya. Tarik nafas, tahan, hembuskan. Tarik nafas, tahan, hembuskan. Tarik nafas, tahan, hembuskan. Satukan telapak tangan Anda dan gosokkan sampai terasa hangat. Gosokkan terus sampai 10 detik. Sesudah itu, letakkan tangan Anda tadi di wajah Anda, lalu ke telinga, lalu ke leher Anda, kemudian ke hati Anda, dan simpan di sana sebentar. Rasakan detak jantung Anda. Tarik napas dalam-dalam dan hembuskan panjang. Silakan membuka mata Anda.
So this is the end of the meditation and thank you.
Ini adalah akhir dari meditasi. Terima kasih.
Oh my God.
Gimana nih teman-teman meditasinya?
Relax gak sih?
Iya, tadi Alin juga coba
ya, meditasi kan? Iya, tadi aku disuruh bayangin tempat kan. Jadi tuh ada satu movie dulu waktu kecil tuh Barbie.
Oke.
Okay. Barbie tahu Rapunzel kan?
Oh iya.
Di situ kayak ada parknya, ada waterfallnya. Ya kan.
Ini bisa kalian coba juga ya di rumah.
Iya kan. Aku merekomendasikan ini banget sih buat kakak-kakak yang lagi mau nyusun skripsi.
Oh iya.
Terus teman-teman yang angkatan 2022 yang nanti bakalan UTS, coba deh. Ya nggak masalah sih kalau misalnya pelarian kalian ternyata apa ya, playing phone atau healing sama teman-teman, it's fine. But cara ini tuh sebenarnya sangat ampuh juga untuk menenangkan pikiran. Terus teman-teman yang merasa bahwa dirinya suka apa ya, kurang kontrol emosi, meledak-meledak emosinya. Coba deh, bakalan membuat kalian jadi pribadi yang lebih sabar juga.
Lebih sabar, lebih tenang. Lebih bisa tenang menghadapi situasi dengan gak emosian juga.
Iya, benar. Jadi apa ya, kalau misalnya kalian ada masalah, bisa dapat jalan keluar yang baik juga. Gak cuman asal ngomong, terus nanti tiba-tiba, ya punya salahnya. Ya kan?
Iya. Oke, ini setelah kita tadi lakukan meditasi, ini ternyata dari Zoom ada yang memberikan pertanyaan lagi.
Wih, oke.
Apa tuh? Sangat semangat ya ini teman-teman ini ya. Jadi dari Pina, adik angkatan 2022, bagaimana cara terbaik untuk belajar bermeditasi?
Oh, so what is the best way for us to learn meditation? Especially for the early student.
Yeah. I think the best way is in the beginning of the meditation, we did the four count breathing. Mm-hmm. Breathe in, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 1, 2, 3, 4. Breathe out, 1, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
Start with that first.
Okay.
It's the simplest meditation. So you're busy counting, so you're focused on counting.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? Otherwise the mind cannot run. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that is a good meditation to start. Well, it's actually a breathing meditation. And I think breathing is something we cannot stop doing.
Yes.
We must always breathe.
Yeah. We not breathe, we're dying.
Exactly. So if you do that breathing meditation, you know, tarik nafas, tahan, tuan nafas, yes, tahan, your mind is focused on that.
Oh, yes.
It'll be very, very useful. You wake up in the morning, that's the meditation you do.
Oh.
The breathing meditation. Okay. And before you go to sleep, do that.
Do that. Okay.
At least you do like 5 to 10 repetitions.
Oh, so, day.
Tarik, tahan, keluar, oh, okay, tahan is one.
Yeah.
And then you do that maybe 5 to 10 times. So whole body will become relaxed. So you can go to sleep easier.
Yeah.
Right? And if you wake up in the morning, that meditation, breathing meditation, energizes you also to start the day.
Okay, so, so someone with insomnia can do this too, right?
Oh, of course, of course. Ah. It's good for insomnia people.
Okay.
Right.
My friend. Teman-teman.
Yeah.
Aku mengkode orang. Semoga kekode. Jadi, menurut Bu Kuna itu, yang paling best way buat kita belajar itu ya tadi itu. Breathing counting ya.
Yeah, breathing counting.
Jadi tarik nafas, tahan, hembuskan. Karena nanti fokusnya bakalan di breathing way lagi. Yeah.
Ulang 5 sampai 10 kali.
5-10 kali pengulangan di situ.
Iya. Terus ada pertanyaan dari Yosia Kurniadi. Kak Yosi, apakah meditasi ini efektif untuk dilakukan saat sedang sakit kepala?
Oh, when we have headaches.
Is it effective to meditation?
Yes, yes. The reason why people have headache is because they're not breathing properly.
Okay.
Right? So when you do the breathing meditation, you send more oxygen to your brain.
Ah, yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Everybody, I noticed, people are breathing very short.
Oh, yeah.
Short breath in, short breath out.
I like that.
Right?
Like
really short. Okay. Right? So you're not taking in enough oxygen. The brain needs oxygen.
Yeah.
So the head needs oxygen.
Yeah.
So when you don't have oxygen, you get stress,
yeah,
and then you get headache.
Yeah. Right? Jadi ini untuk yang sakit kepala itu meditasi ini benar-benar membantu banget ya. Karena kan tadi di awal juga Bro Kuna bilang bahwa meditasi itu kan tentang pernafasan juga ya. Jadi semakin banyak oksigen yang masuk ke kepala itu semakin gak sakit kepala, semakin bagus gitu. Kan kebanyakan orang kalau nafas kayak cepet ya. Jadi kayak itu gak, iya kurang oksigennya masuk ke kepala gitu.
Jadi terus, sebenarnya malah meditasi itu bisa ngurangin sakit kepala juga.
Iya benar. Ini ada juga pertanyaan dari Maliak dan Stephen. Jadi Yoel sama Stephen.
Oke. Okay.
Bagaimana cara kita agar bisa mengetahui bahwa kondisi kita ini benar-benar sedang dalam kondisi bermeditasi?
Oh, how do we know that we are in meditation condition? Like we know that we are meditating. We close our eyes, right?
Yes.
So how do we know that?
Okay. If you're present, it means you're meditating.
Oh, okay.
Right? Most people are sitting here present, but absent somewhere else.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't that what happens in the classroom? The body is here, but the mind is somewhere
else.
Right. So meditation is the same. When you're sitting down and meditating, you are present. You know the awareness that I am here. Right? I'm sitting here, I'm breathing in, breathing out. That consciousness, that awareness that I'm breathing in, breathing out, means you're present.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So that's your, what you call, checking in with yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're checking in with yourself. Am I here or am I gone?
Okay.
Right? That you're breathing and you're counting and that you are sitting still. You will feel body sensations. Maybe sometimes a little bit itchy here, a little bit of aches and pains there. But that's normal, right? But the whole idea is to be focused and being present here. And I'm aware that I'm sitting here. And that's it. Yeah. You know you're there. If you're somewhere else, come back.
Yeah, but I'm agree. Like, sometimes we feel like we lost ourselves.
Yeah. Yes. So what happened? Where did you go?
Yes.
So you make a commitment. When you want to do meditation, you make a commitment. Today, at this time, I'm going to do meditation. And I'm going to give myself 5 minutes, only 5 minutes, right? And I'm going to focus and discipline myself. If you can do that, that's the beginning of your discipline, and you create that habit.
Mm.
It's all habit, actually.
Yes.
Right? You wake up in the morning, you go and brush your teeth. It's a habit. Mm. It's automatic, right?
Yes.
Right? And it's the same thing. Make it a habit. Mm. It's a good habit. Why not?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jadi teman-teman, gimana sih kita bisa tahu kalau kita lagi meditasi? Ya kita merasakan ya kalau kita tuh lagi meditasi.
Yeah.
Karena aku yakin sih kalau misalnya kalian lagi nggak fokus tuh kalian berasa loh. Kalau misalnya kalian tuh lagi,
kemana-mana
aku, gitu. Aku kemana ya tadi? Terus balik lagi gitu. Jadi kalau misalnya kalian lagi meditasi terus, ih kok badanku sakit ya? Apa? Ya itu berarti kalian lagi meditasi gitu. Cuman kalau misalnya tiba-tiba kalian ini terus tiba-tiba diam, kalian buka mata. Nah itu udah. Lost focus,
iya kan?
Karena kalian sadar bahwa kalian nggak di sini sih, aku lagi ngelamun gitu.
Ikarannya lagi kemana-mana.
Hmm.
Oke, ini ada pertanyaan terakhir ya dari Alida Nela. Ini pertanyaan langsung pakai bahasa Inggris, jadi aku langsung bacain aja ya. Is it important to have daily meditation practice? How does meditation relate to daily life?
It is important to have daily meditation practice.
Yeah.
Because then your mind. Your mind, body, spirit is in alignment together, and it's consistent, right? It's like any other activity. If you go to the gym or you go running, when you stop, there's no consistency. Then it's difficult to get back to it again.
Yeah.
You know, they say that if you stop your routine for one day, it takes 3 weeks to catch up again.
Mm.
You know? So what I would suggest is, that's the first part of the question, right? That you keep a routine and what's the second part of the question?
How does meditation relate to daily life?
Meditation, how does it relate to daily life? Very,
very,
very, very strongly relates to daily life because when you are a meditating person, it's difficult to get upset, it's difficult to get angry, it's difficult to get irritated because you're always feeling calm.
Yeah.
You feel peaceful, you know, and when you have that vibration inside you that you are peaceful and calm, things can happen around you that can be disturbing to others but not disturbing to you, because for you is you accept people and situations as they are, right? Because I'm calm on the inside. It's this thing, we cannot control everything on the outside, but we can control everything on the inside, because the inside world is my world. The outside world is by so many people out there. So you cannot control and judge things on the outside. You can control things on the inside. So make your inner world peaceful first. Then the outer world will look peaceful to you. Even if there is problem, it's okay. It's their problem. I'm fine. I'm not affected by it.
Okay, so jadi buat teman-teman ya, apa namanya? Kalau meditasi itu bisa jadi rutinitas kalau kita jadikan sebuah kebiasaan.
Betul banget.
Kayak misalnya mungkin kalian pagi-pagi baru bangun buka HP ya, itu coba
diganti
meditasi. Nah, itu bakalan
karena kalian terbiasa, bakalan jadi seluruh rutinitas yang baik juga.
Iya, benar.
Dan meditasi itu juga sangat-sangat-sangat relate dengan kehidupan kita. Karena kan itu menenangkan bukan hanya pikiran, tapi juga soul ya, jiwa kita.
Jiwa kita, jadi kita nggak di-distract untuk gampang marah.
Nggak gampang.
Iya, lain.
Nggak gampang kesel lah ya sama orang.
Iya, benar.
Apalagi buat cewek-cewek yang kita ya, mood swing-nya kan
rada
turun. Iya, naik turun. Dan itu bisa membantu banget. Karena kan kita nggak bisa kontrol lingkungan luar ya. Benar. Orang luar kita hanya bisa kontrol
diri sendiri.
Jadi setelah kita nggak gampang terpengaruh dengan itu ya, gimana caramu untuk mengontrol diri?
Fokus ke diri kita sendiri.
Fokus
sendiri.
Benar. Iya, betul sekali. And that's the last question, but I have my question, right? So meditation, I start by 5 minutes and then 10 minutes like that. But if someone not have a high patience in their self, and then they start to counting like just 5 minutes and then they start, is that distract?
Yeah, that happens. So when you're doing, that's why I'm saying do the breathing meditation. Mm. To just focus on the breath in and the breath out, and you're sitting there, and put your timer for 2 minutes. Start. Try 2 minutes.
Okay.
Right. If you can handle 2 minutes, you can go to 3, or maybe 4, or maybe 5 after that. If you're trying to do 5 or 10 minutes straight away on the first go, it will be difficult. Right. So, don't set too high a standard. Try to be conservative and say, I will start slow and I will progress from there. Right? Nobody becomes a meditation expert overnight.
Yes.
Right? It takes many years of practice. And personally, I know people who can just sit and meditate for 3 hours, 6 hours. Mm. They're just in another world. Yeah. Right? So it starts slow.
Jadi buat teman-teman yang menyadari diri, termasuk saya sendiri yang tidak sabaran ya sebenarnya, tidak terlalu sabaran, ya jangan jadikan meditasi itu sebuah challenge ya. Jangan ambil lama. Jadi kayak, kalau misalnya kalian udah yakin mau meditasi, ya lakukan dari hati ya. Bukan karena keharusan ya.
Iya, dan kalau misalnya kalian ngerasa, aduh kayaknya kalau meditasi dilakuin 5 menit awal kayak lamaan ya, gitu kan. Kalau misalnya kalian gampang ke distract orangnya, kan bisa kok ngelakuin meditasi ya 2 menit dulu. Kalian set timer 2 menit dulu, nanti bertahap, semakin bertahap. Nanti lama-lama jadi kebiasaan dan kalian bakalan nyaman untuk melakukan meditasi.
Dan gitu. Jangan pernah ngitung waktu.
Iya, fokus aja.
Jalan, ya kalau mau jalan, jalan aja. Fokus ke pernapasan tadi.
Iya, betul.
And before we close, what am I forgetting something? We forget to allow you to introduce yourself first.
Oh, okay.
Yes! The audience maybe not know who is this.
Yeah.
Yes! Yeah. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. If we can, we can introduce even at the end.
Yes.
Everyone calls me Bro Kuna. It's actually short for Brother Kuna.
Ah.
Right? So, I'm from Singapore originally.
Okay.
Was born and raised in Singapore. I have been always wanting to help people, right? It's become my thing from a very early age, right? So here's the thing, when you set your mind on something that you want to do, you know, God or the universe will start to make the road for you, the path for you to find it. And from Singapore, I ended up in Surabaya, you know? It's just that it's a path that's open. So where this path will go from here, I'm not sure. I'm basically a trainer and a life coach, mostly in transformation of people. I'm also a 5-walk instructor. So I help people go through doing the 5-walk experience to take on challenges and to break through blocks and limitations. I have my own company in Singapore, and also I'm doing training around Asia mostly, for corporate, for students, for public in general. And I covers a wide range of areas regarding health, relationship, leadership. I'm also a life coach, so I have a lot of clients who call me and talk about their personal problems, you know, whether it's relationship or whether it's financial or whether they themselves are feeling not good enough, things like that. So I feel that this is my line of work and this is my purpose in life, and I want to keep doing it, and I'm happy and enjoying doing it.
Yeah. I'm happy for
it. Thank you for asking me that question.
Thank you for understanding us. Yeah.
Jadi teman-teman, Bro Kuna itu lahir besar di Singapura. Dari beliau masih kecil ya, di usia muda sudah ada minat untuk melayani ya, untuk
melayani orang,
membantu orang-orang juga, dan akhirnya ended up di Surabaya. Terus Bro Kuna juga ada seorang life coach. Punya company sendiri ya,
di Singapura,
perusahaan sendiri di Singapura. Beliau juga kadang dengan klien-klien yang punya masalah personal sendiri. Ya, mereka ini juga menelepon Bro Kuna untuk bercerita.
Bercerita tentang ya personal.
Ya, Bro Kuna juga life training itu mostly di Asia ya.
Iya.
Kebanyakan di Asia. Terus juga untuk perusahaan, untuk kita yang lagi mahasiswa-mahasiswi, masih anak-anak sekolah juga. Terus secara umum masyarakat umum juga bisa gitu. Jadi kalau misalnya kalian mau cerita-cerita juga boleh. Is it? Can the audience maybe just talking about their personal problems to you? Maybe.
Sure.
Oh, sure? Okay.
Anytime. Yeah. We're here to help. So, you know, the young people are the future of the world.
Yeah.
And the world can only be better if the people, the young people are better.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. So let's work with them.
Okay. Okay. Jadi kita kan sebagai penerus bangsa ya,
generasi muda. Yes.
Generasi muda. Jadi kita kalau mau negerinya baik ya, penerusnya juga harus baik.
Iya, betul. Ya guys, smart guys.
Sangat menjalani hidup teman-temanku. Gak kerasa ya, Olin?
Iya.
Ini udah berapa lama kita?
Enggak lama-lama juga sebenarnya.
Iya, tapi kayak enggak kerasa banget akhirnya kita sudah ada di akhir sesi kita hari ini.
Thank you so much for coming here with your team.
Yes,
sharing your
vision. Thank you very much.
I hope all my friends can hear the motivation word from you like we did.
Sure.
It's really motivating, really. Thank you so much. It's really an honor for us to Maybe next time we can do the training again.
Yes, sure.
Jadi guys, sekarang waktunya kita untuk ngapain nih?
Jadi ya kita kan sebagai murid teladan Stevens ya.
Kita masih teladan.
Masih teladan. Kita mau ngajak teman-teman nih kalau misalnya kalian berminat masuk Stevens, jadi kayak kita juga gitu kan. Aku mau ngenalin beberapa prodi yang ada di Stevens. Yang pertama ilmu keperawatan kayak kita. Okay. Jadi kalau yang kalian pengen masuk ilmu keperawatan, bisa langsung join sama kita di sini.
Cepet ada event sama Audi guys, jadi kalian bisa sign up di S1. Maaf.
Okay, skip bagian itu. Selanjutnya ada D3 fisioterapi. Ini mungkin orang dengernya kayak pijet. Ini bukan tukar pijet ya guys.
Ini yang teman-teman fisio dengerin kita jangan marah ya, jangan marah bukan gitu. Tapi emang generally orang-orang taunya itu adalah pijet-pijetan ya, tapi bukan. Ya itu salah satu terapi yang fisioterapi tawarkan.
Tapi enggak
bukan cuma.
Kalau mau tahu bisa langsung join ya teman-teman.
Sure.
Oke, terus yang tiga. Ada D3 keperawatan.
Prodinya para suhu.
Prodinya para suhu.
Para suhu.
Terus ada untuk kakak-kakak yang habis menyelesaikan
S1.
Pendidikan ilmu keperawatan, terus pengen lanjut buat profesinya, bisa langsung join sama kita di Profesinas.
Jadi bukan dari Stikvin aja ya?
Iya, dari luar juga bisa.
Iya, kakak-kakak dari luar, join Stikvin family aja.
Iya, dan yang terakhir ada S1 administrasi rumah sakit buat, ini masuk prodi baru tapi sudah dimulai.
Iya, dan sudah ada penghuninya.
Sudah ada penghuninya, sudah ada angkatan pertamanya. Jadi buat kalian yang mau berkecimpung di dunia administrasi rumah sakit, bisa langsung join sama kita di sini buat belajar bareng ya teman-teman.
Jadi kalau misalnya interest sama IT, akuntansi, kayak gitu-gitu, langsung aja daftar di S1 administrasi rumah sakit. Dan kita udah buka gelombang ini ya.
Daftarannya.
Jadi ada gelombang yang namanya gelombang spesial, gelombang istimewa nih ya. Mulai dari bulan ini nih, Oktober sampai Desember nanti, tahun 2022. Nah, di situ benefitnya kalian bisa dapat potongan sebesar 25% dari dana pembangunan dan free biaya pendaftaran. Terus gelombang pertama mulai dari kapan nih?
Gelombang pertama itu dari Januari sampai Mei 2023. Itu kalian bisa dapat potongan dana pembangunan 20%.
Oke, dan terus ada gelombang kedua, itu dimulai dari bulan Juni sampai Juli 2023. Itu benefitnya 10% ya, dana pembangunan dapat potongan 10%.
Terus yang ketiga, tiga ya?
Iya
dong. Tiga itu ada dari, mulai dari 1 Agustus sampai 31 Agustus 2023, kalian bisa dapat potongan dana pembangunan sebanyak 5%. Nah, itu kalian bisa dapetin dengan cara kalian cuma ngikutin acara ngojek Stickfish.
Jadi kan ini pakai sertifikat ya.
Ya, pantengin Stickfish juga dan ya screenshot poster Stickfish terus bisa kalian share ke yang lain. Terus untuk yang gelombang terakhir.
Nah, terus ada gelombang terakhir, gelombang keempat itu dimulai dari tanggal 1 sampai 30 September tahun 2023. Itu juga dapat potongan 5% dari dana pembangunan, tapi itu bisa dapat kalau misalnya kalian sudah melunasi biaya pendidikan.
Ya, dan juga untuk kan tadi udah disebutin ya, benefitnya juga dapat sertifikat nih buat buat calon mahasiswa baru yang mau mendaftar di Stickfin. Tapi buat jangan sedih, buat mahasiswa Stickfinnya juga ya, kalian juga bisa dapetin sertifikat buat nama-nama SKP
ya, ya betul juga. Dan juga kalau kalian ikut ngajek, kalian bisa dapat door prize satu sendiri.
Karena saya juga sudah pernah
ini ya, sudah testimoni.
Testimoni.
No tipu-tipu. Jadi kalau misalnya kalian butuh uang tambahan untuk jajan, bisa langsung ikut ngojek aja.
Yeah.
Biar dapat door prize tadi itu.
Tapi persyaratannya harus share poster ngojek dong.
Iya, di link pendaftarannya. Yeah. Jadi kalian daftar, kalian sertakan juga screenshot share posternya. Sebanyak terus kalian jangan lupa juga dong guys buat follow IG at stickfin.surabaya buat update terus nih informasi tentang ngojek selanjutnya atau info-info soal Stickfin lain.
Terus kalian juga bisa langsung untuk mengetahui info-infonya bisa langsung kunjungi website kita di www.stickfin.ac.id. Dan untuk teman-teman yang mau mendaftar online bisa langsung ke stickfin.online/register.
Jangan lupa dong guys selalu untuk subscribe YouTube kita di Stickfin Surabaya. Lihat dong semua konten-kontennya karena emang se-edukatif, semenarik itu. Dan kalau udah nonton, langsung like, comment, dan share. Jadi kita selesai. Thank you so much, Prabuna and your team.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Audi.
Oke, sampai jumpa dua minggu lagi dengan topik yang berbeda, guys. Jadi ngojek,
ngobrol, genius, kekinian.
Malam minggu seru karena ada aku dan kamu.
Di acara ngojek.
Apa itu ngojek?
Ngojek itu ngobrol jenius kekinian.
Ngojek ngobrol jenius kekinian.